Okay, well, let's have a look at how we can build our first report leveraging a wizard.
Oh, boy.
I already have Report Builder installed, so I'm just going to click on the shortcut on my taskbar to open Power BI Paginated Report Builder. Here we see the Getting Started window, and I'm going to use the Table or Matrix wizard to create the first report. Step one, choose a data set.
Yep.
Well, it's a new report.
Yep.
We don't have a data set yet, so we're just going to click Next. We need a source of data to connect to, so I'm going to click Next, or New, excuse me. And here in the drop-down list, we see the supported data sources.
That's right.
All right, well, the data for AdventureWorks resides in an Azure SQL database. And then I build up the connection properties. I'll authenticate by using SQL Server authentication, and I have a dedicated account named Read-Only User. I deliberately name it that just to emphasize that this account doesn't need privileges beyond retrieving the data that the report needs. I then go ahead and select the database, in this case the AdventureWorks DW2020. Go ahead, test that connection, success. And then the connection string that was just built has been copied in to define our data source. Next step of the wizard then is to define a data set that will use that data source. And so here you see the graphical designer. We'll introduce it in the next module. But it's simple in the sense that it exposes to you the structure of the relational database here in terms of tables and views. I'm going to build out, Chris, that sales order report and show you how the wizard can just do it in a matter of minutes. So what we find at AdventureWorks is that the reseller sales fact table here, it has a sales order line number. It has a quantity and a unit price and a sale amount. All right, notice that I don't need to write a query.
That's right.
And then I need some related data, so the name of the product is found in the DIM product table. It's the English product name. Now, I'm going to apply a filter. So there's this applied filters area, and by clicking the icon that you see here, the filter icon, I'm going to go ahead and define a filter that should filter for a specific sales order number. Do you remember sales order 51721 was the example that I used in a previous video?
I did not.
I do remember this one from heart. And then there's this little checkbox here to say, will it become a parameter? Of course it will. We want this report to work across every sales order. To put this to the test, I can preview the data. Looks good, and I'd expect that there are 72, and I memorized that.
That's right.
There are 72 sales order lines. By clicking Next, then, the data set has been defined. And so the second final stage of the wizard is just to lay this out in a grid structure.
Yep.
All right, so on the row groupings, I'm going to put the sales order number, I'm going to put the English product name, and in the values, I'll place the order quantity. In fact, I can double-click unit price, and the sale amount. I'll just point out the drop-down list here does allow you to customize any aggregation.
Yeah.
For now, for this simple demo, we'll leave it with the default of sum. So the final stage of the table or matrix wizard is, well, how do I want to lay this out in terms of groupings and totaling? For this demo, I'm just going to turn off all subtotals and grand totals. Also turn off expand collapse.
Yep.
This is intended to print. I don't want anything collapsed. I want to see it all as a simple list. There's a preview of what's to come. I can see the report bear trembling in anticipation.
It is quite exciting.
And here's our first report.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's put it to the test with a preview. And voila, for sales order 51721, we see a multi-page report.
Yes, and I think one of the reasons that say, SQL Server Reporting Services veterans in the past may have had feelings towards the wizard that were not as excited as mine, was that at the end of the wizard, oftentimes you had to apply a very dated theme. And so the theme that would come out would not make the report look beautiful. I don't think the point of the wizard right now is to make the report beautiful. I think for a lot of people, they're just looking to create a table oftentimes when they're starting with paginated reports. This shows you how simple it is to do that. And then what the purpose of some of these videos will do is like, how can I make that table look even better or even more dynamic as I move forward?
Well, that leads beautifully into our next video.
Oh, that's good.
How we're going to lay out reports and customize look and feel with properties and even dynamic assignments with expressions.
Yeah, that's great.